Today we're going to be installing an alarm.com SEM or system enhancement module into a Honeywell Vista wired security system. This includes Honeywell Vista 10P, 15P, 20P, and 21IP as long as the panel is from 2005 and above. The Vista 21IP, you would just need to move the jumper, disabling internal communicators, which we do have a video on our YouTube page doing already. It's very simple. So today, we're going to start off by showing you how to wire this or pre-wire this SEM module up in order to install into the wired security system. So what I'm going to do first is tell you a little bit about what you'll need. You'll need some 22x4, 20x4, or 18x4 gauge wire to come from the communicator to the panel. This does not come with the SEM module. You'll need a small flathead screwdriver, as well as some wire strippers. A drill and a basic toolkit is also handy, as you will see as we continue this installation process. The first thing you want to do is open up the SEM module box. You want to keep everything in manufacturing in resellable condition in case you need to return it. Right off the gate, you'll see that the system enhancement module installation guide. This thing has some key information, such as what should be coming with the SEM module. Compatibility, as you can see, this is where you would locate if your system is 2005 or above, as well as the model number. So you'll see WA15P, and then the year that this was manufactured. So this is helpful, as well as all the other information about compatibility with Vista panels. All right, so now what we want to do is remove all the other packaging and welcome items to the side, and we're going to remove the actual SEM module, there it is, as well as the other installation items from the box, and we can move this to the side for later purposes. Now I'm going to place this SEM module here, and I'm going to depress these two tabs, exposing the insides of the actual module itself. Now that we're zoomed in a little bit, just to go over some basic stuff, just to simplify this installation, you won't have to worry about this terminal, or this terminal, or this jumper, because it's no longer used. We'll just be working with these four terminals, which will simplify the installation process. Now, you want to get your 22x4 wire, or you know any other setup that you have, like I said, with 20 or 18x4. You're going to cut the red wire out, so you'll only be left with yellow or white. In this case, we have white, black, and green. All right, and this opposite end is for installation into the panel. I'll explain why later. This is where it's very simple. This is a very simple installation process. You can follow on page 9, which we have listed right here, where it gets wired. So here's the SEM module, right? So the first zone we'll be working with is GND or ground. This will receive the black wire, and this is for ground. Simply install that into its terminal. Make sure it's screwed in there pretty firmly. Next will be the green directly above it. Make sure this goes into its designated slot. Do the same on this one, screw it in. And lastly, for this particular wire, you want to delegate the yellow or the white wire directly above that. And you can go ahead and screw that one in as well. Very simple procedure. All right. Now you'll be noticing an interesting setup here where you have the 12 volt with this device inside. This is a fuse. So you want to remove this red wire. All right, and now you'll notice this end is for the installation process, which will be part of our next chapter. And this opposite end is for delegating into this terminal here. So the red wire will go into the 12V. As directed, go ahead and screw that down firmly. And now our SEM module is pre-wired. is go ahead and open up the Honeywell Vista 20P panel. And we're going to go ahead and disconnect the ground and the positive from the battery. Like so. Now we're going to go ahead and pull out the power transformer. Now that the backup battery has been pulled, disconnected from the panel, we're just going to simply remove the power transformer. Place that to the side. Now that the system has been powered down, you'll see that I have mounted the system enhancement module mounting bracket and secured it next to the panel, where you can also see a little knockout hole here, where we're going to now insert our pre-wired system enhancement module, delegate the wires through this hole, and it should clip in pretty simple. You'll notice you want to insert in these two slots first with the antennas facing up, like so. And simply clip it into place like so, making sure it's secured. And now, that everything has been secured, we can now put on the cover. I have the cover here. You want to make sure the antennas run out the top of the panel. The small one's going to come underneath, like so. Now you can take your cover. You want the small one to go out through the first hole and the larger antenna out the third hole. This is the LTE version. So put it in its place like that. Securing that into place. And now you can go ahead and peel off the 3M sticky tape that you have. You can peel it off like so. You can go ahead and secure one end of it. And now the second one. And there you go, just like that. There we go. Now make sure, before installing, of course, that you do have good cellular signal, which our technicians will assist you with remotely over the phone. You're going to take your power wire, run that through here, which will go directly to your battery lead, which I'll show you in just a second. And your data terminals, your data wires, to run through that same hole. Like so. So we have it mounted next to the panel. That looks good. And now we'll move on to wiring up the actual SEM's wires to the actual Honeywell panel. Next, you want to go ahead and take the power wire that's wired directly from the system enhancement module and go ahead and connect it to the positive end of the Honeywell Vista panel's terminals for the battery, like so. Very simple. You don't want to plug it in quite yet. And then you have the negative end. These will remain unplugged for now. And next, we will be locating the three wires that I showed you how to pre-wire coming directly from the system enhancement module. And we're going to delegate them into their respective terminals. You can see the terminals listed right under. Terminal 4, 5, 6, and 7. That's the keypad bus on the Vista 20P. I'm going to go ahead and take the black wire, and I'm going to run that into terminal 4. Terminal 6 will receive the green wire. Do the same for this one. And then terminal 7 will receive the yellow, in our case white wire. And now we have the system enhancement module completely wired into the Honeywell Vista panel.